And welcome to Significant TV, Significant Stories, Significant Entrepreneurs. I'm your host, Fran McNeil, and joining me in the studio are two very dynamic entrepreneurs who also serve in a social way towards a social mission. Our first guest is Candace Roberts. She is founder of Quantum Think, a graphic design and branding company that primarily services the pharmaceutical industry. Our second guest is Maria Basagio, president of Sage Insights, a consulting firm that helps entrepreneurs and corporations work more strategically. Now, I mentioned that they are here because they are serving entrepreneurs in a social way. What exactly does that mean? Well, let's find out by talking with Candace Roberts and Maria Basagio. Candace, welcome to Significant TV.
Thank you
so
much.
How are you today?
I'm wonderful, thank you.
Good. And Maria, how are you today?
I'm doing well, thank you so much.
Well, I know both of you through your really excellent work with Athena PowerLink. Candace, you're co-founder of Athena PowerLink. And Maria, you are chair of the Board of Governors. Athena PowerLink. Candace, this is a very important organization. Why did you originally decide to be a co-founder way back when? What's the significant story behind that?
Well, I was on the NABO, National Association of Women Business Owners Board of Directors, and I learned about these two women in Pittsburgh who had founded the Athena PowerLink program as a way to give women the opportunity to have access to what we tend to think of as the old boy network. And so women business owners typically don't want to share their troubles and ask for help. And this is a program that lets them do that in a very safe environment. And it was highly successful in Pittsburgh. And I thought, we're bigger than Pittsburgh. It should be in Philadelphia. So
that's so, you know, that's a really powerful statement. Helping entrepreneurs and specifically helping women. Maria, you're on the governing board, and what does that exactly mean for women business owners? What does the program do, and how do you and your role kind of help make that happen?
Well, the Athena PowerLink program provides advisory panels for women business owners that meet our eligibility requirements, and it gives them a group of professionals that are put together to address their specific needs. So every advisory panel is customized for the particular woman business owner. And they work with her for the 1 year period of time for a very nominal fee to her. And they help her work through the challenges that are right now stifling her growth. And what's nice about that is that not only do the Athena PowerLink does the Athena PowerLink program help the women business owners, but we're also helping the greater Philadelphia business community, because as we help them achieve their growth targets, then we're helping the economy in our area through new job growth and so forth. And if you don't mind me sharing, what's significant as well is I think that sometimes it may be less known about how significant the growth is in women-owned businesses. American Express Womenable did a study back in 2016 that was measuring the growth rate since the recession. And they found that during the time period of 2007 to 2016, in that 9 year period of time, the growth rate of businesses, new businesses overall, was a little bit over 9%. But when they took a look at the growth rate of women-owned businesses, it was approximately 45%. So there are a lot of women out there who are entrepreneurs who could really benefit from an advisory panel.
That makes a lot of sense. Now, Candace, this is an ambitious goal. Having this vision that women will, as a result of having advisory boards, improve and succeed, there may be people that say, I don't know how that happens. I bet you have some success stories that are important to share. Would you share a few?
Absolutely. Each panel is built to the women's specific needs. So, for example, we had a gal whose business is to write the pharmaceutical inserts, those white PI forms that nobody ever wants to read, but really, really should. And she had a $4 million size business, wanted to grow to $20 million. And so her panel had folks from the pharmaceutical industry, systems people, HR people, because if you're going to grow at that rate, you need some significant changes in the way that your business operates. And so her panel helped her do that. Along the way, she was told by the pharmaceutical industry people she needed to have an offshore location, that the industry was going to soon require that of all their vendors. So they helped her investigate locations in Hong Kong and China and Taiwan and the Philippines and even Ireland, and she ultimately chose the Philippines. So a very wonderful success story there, opened her business there. Another one is a gal who does closed captioning for public television and for the in the university arena, and wanted to take her business national. So she needed folks who, again, how do you extend the technology of what you're doing locally to what you can do nationwide? And that was a few years ago, and the technology was certainly not what it is today. So today you might think, oh, that's a pretty easy thing to do. But when we first started, that was not an easy thing to do. And so her panel did help her grow her business. She created additional jobs and additional profitability for herself and for her business. And then another one who's underway right now makes some really wonderful sauces, Italian sauces and Indian sauces, and she's doing nicely in Whole Foods distribution. Her panel has food experts, and they are helping her look at her distribution, how to get in greater coverage, like how could she get in Wegmans, how can she get in some of the national chains, how can she get her sauces nationwide. And so she's well on her way to do that. Already I think she's hired sales team and distributors. So again, the notion of Athena PowerLink is to take a business that's successful and help them get to that next level. And so it's very specific, and the success has been great. So.
And you've really shared measurable examples across multiple industries. So this concept of panels that are diverse and assigned to help someone with a specific issue is really powerful. Maria, I'm sure some of our viewers are now saying, oh my goodness, I've been in business for a while, I'm a woman entrepreneur, or I know a woman entrepreneur that wants to take her business to the next level. What's the specific process that they need to go through in order to be part of this wonderful program?
Well, we have certain eligibility requirements, and some of those are that the woman has to have been in business for at least 2 years, and if she is a services-based business, her annual revenues need to be at least $100,000 per year, and if she's a product-based business, then it needs to be $250,000 per year. Those are minimum thresholds. Most of our panels, especially now, are certainly much more than that minimum threshold, but those are just the basic eligibility requirements. She also needs to have at least 2 full-time employees or the equivalent. The 1099 model is so acceptable today that that's fine as well. So if she meets that eligibility requirement, then we have an application that's available on our website. Our website is APL-NABO, N-A-W-B-O-D-V, for Delaware Valley. So APL-NABODV.org. But if she looks at that website, she can get the application form, completes that, and then that's sent to us. We review it, and if based on that application, it appears that she meets those eligibility requirements, then we schedule an interview with her and 3 members of the governing body. And during that phone interview with her, they're going over a little bit of what she has shared with us on the application, but there's also other criteria that we want to learn from her. First and foremost, is she coachable? Because if she's not coachable, then we shouldn't take her time, and we shouldn't take the time of the professionals who are giving their time pro bono. They're volunteering for this. No one's getting paid to sit on an advisory panel. And also, she just wouldn't get the most out of a panel. So is she coachable? But also, are her financials such that she's really in has the opportunity for a growth trajectory? We're not providing advisory panels for turnaround situations. We're providing advisory panels to help them really extend their growth and really reach their growth targets. So we're looking at all of that. And for that reason, we require that they send us 2 to 3 years of their financials with their application so that we can also assess their viability. So after the phone interview, then if everything looks like she's a potential for an advisory panel, then we schedule again 3 or 4 of the members of the governing body to go out and meet her on site. And what we're looking for there is just how are her operations running? Are there some issues that perhaps we might need to help her with from that point of view? And also, is that set up? It also gives us a chance to make sure that she's at least a truly active 51% owner of her business and not just by paper. And I'll share with you a little example, and I won't share with you the name, but give you a little example of one time when we went out, and actually Candace was on this on-site interview, but we were at the applicant's location, and we saw that although she was truly the business owner and her husband was really the technical support, her husband had the big corner office with the windows and spacious room and all that, and she had this little side office that was inky-dinky tiny. So we basically looked at her and said, you meet all the qualifications, but until you're in that corner office, you're not getting a panel. And she got herself in that corner office, and that proved to us that she really was in charge of the business. She was really at least the 51% business owner, and that she was going to be coachable, and that she was willing to make some decisions based on the advice of the board. So she had her panel, and she was quite successful.
That's a great story. Candace, the time is going very quickly, and yet I know there are some more examples of how the panels, when put in place, make a difference for business owners. We had talked earlier about one that you wanted to share.
Well, one of our early panels was a gal who does packaging of dry foods, teas, cocos, and she's in the Reading area. And after her panel helped her think about growing her business, she was actually able to sell a portion of her business for $8 million. And prior to that, she had no idea her business was even worth close to $8 million. But her panel showed her where the value was in her business, where the opportunities were in her business, and again, fulfilling our mission to create greater personal wealth for women business owners, greater profitability, and jobs, you know, really transformational in the region. So she was a wonderful, all of them have been really wonderful examples of all of those things. So
I really hear the passion and the purpose from both of you as a co-founder, as chair of the governing body. Maria, can you talk very briefly about some of the qualifications of the panel members? Because they play such an integral part in the success.
They absolutely do, and you're right. And as both of us have mentioned, the panels are customized to the women business owners' needs. So the way that we find professionals in the greater Philadelphia area, so it's men and women professionals in Philadelphia, in South Jersey, in Delaware, who are actually known by members of the governing body. So they're in our network. We know that they have the expertise. They're not just somebody that has a title by their name, but we know them. We've somehow worked with them. We have seen their success. So we truly believe that they have skills and expertise to offer to help the women business owners overcome their challenges. So that's part of our vetting process, but we try to find professionals in human resources, human capital, in strategy, operations, marketing, sales, legal, finance. And what also is interesting is that over the years we've realized that while we would be in the interview process and we'd be asking the candidates if they felt comfortable with being able to read their financial reports, and often we would always get the answer, yes, we would. But as we would be going through their panels, we'd realize they really needed some financial help. So regardless of what other disciplines they may need and areas of expertise they may need on their panel, they're always going to get somebody with financial expertise. And they will also have someone always from the governing body who will serve as their mentor.
Very, very powerful. We have literally seconds left. What's one thing that you want our viewing audience to remember about Athena PowerLink? 3 to 5 words.
If you're a woman business owner that meets the qualifications, sign up for this gem. This is a wonderful, wonderful program.
Terrific. And Maria?
To add to that, I'll say if you're a professional in the area and you believe that you could offer some assistance to a woman business owner and have interest in serving on an advisor panel, please contact us. We'd love to meet you.
Excellent. Significant stories, significant entrepreneurs. If you're ready to take your business to the next level and you're a woman business owner, there's a resource waiting for you. Check out Athena PowerLink. Maria Bisaggio and Candace Roberts are resources that can help you get to the next level.